Hi guys, welcome back to Pass the Move. And yes, of course, it's still travel time, and we are with Athletico Bilbao. And if you missed out on the last episode, since then, things have not gone well at all. Bottom of the table with 0 points is not exactly what we envisioned. Since that first game, which we showed in the last episode against Malaga, the 1-0 loss, we seem to just barely lose. So against Villarreal, it was a 1-0 loss as well. A bit disappointing, but Villarreal are somewhat on the same level as Athletico Bilbao in this, this year, essentially. And Levante was the one that was more disappointing because we were at home and we are a better team than Levante and we should have been winning, but instead we lost 2-1 despite getting the opening goal, and while chasing the winner we actually conceded in the 88th minute, so a bit poor. But we did manage to beat Newcastle 2-0 convincingly in the Europa League, and of course Stephen Defoe getting sent off in the 46th minute rather helped us on in the second half. Against Atletico Madrid though, of course a better team than us, but I was hoping that we could at least hold on for the draw in a 1-1 thing, 1-1 when it was 1-1 basically, 1-1 thing. But yeah, Vieto had different plans and managed to get his hat-trick complete in the 86th minute. So we're going to be facing Barcelona today. Of course, not the easiest team to face, especially if you've been losing recently. But yeah, I think I'm going to have a quick look at our tactics, see what we can do here. I've taken off being more expressive. I've left on roam from positions. We're going to be playing at a higher tempo, and I think we'll go for more direct as well. Of course, we're still closing down more. But yeah, let's see what happens here. I think we'll keep the team as is. We've just dropped them a little bit so it can help our counter. When we want to go up to control and whatnot, we'll push up, of course, because otherwise it doesn't make any sense. Sorry about that. If you didn't say bless you, then you're pretty much the devil himself. But yeah, let's just get into today's game. Of course, Muniain and Akitske there, I guess. I don't even know how you say that name. They're obviously not too suited to the winger role because, you know, they like to cut in on their preferred foot. I'm sure they'll be okay, you know. The difference between an inside forward and a winger is not too much, of course. Normally, the key attribute for me is decision-making as well as the finishing itself, because that's the whole point why you have an inside forward, is because you want him to finish more. Anyways, of course, Barcelona are the favourites for today's game. For some reason, the odds expert thinks it'll be a close encounter. Based on recent form, though, it shouldn't be close at all. Barcelona getting 9 points out of 4 games, winning 3 times and only losing to Espanyol 2-0 away from home. Kind of a surprising result, but especially considering Espanyol, that was the only win they got so far. But yeah, still early days in the season. Board aren't too happy. I can't actually afford to... let me see here. Do these things quickly. So yeah, what I was saying was that I can't actually afford to resign from this club, because I'm getting a bit of a reputation that I'm just resigning from everyone. For me, when it comes to Football Manager, I struggle to stick to one team for a while unless I'm actually enjoying it. It's never really got anything to do with the results. It's not why I'm not enjoying it. It's just if I feel like I'm just getting a little bit bored probably of the club, or maybe the league, maybe the board aren't cooperating with me, so I just don't want to be at this club anymore. And it kind of happened here almost immediately, if I'm honest. And it was just, the simple reason was that because of their self-imposed, we're going to witness a messy free kick is what I meant. Gonna get another chance to see it through 3D. But yeah, the transfer policy that they, you know, self-imposed on themselves was it's pretty stupid if you ask me. What a huge deflection, man. I don't even think it should count as a messy figure. I think it counts because his was going on target anyways. We're gonna get another highlight immediately here. But I should start pushing up soon. Messi's just going nuts. It just doesn't make sense to stay on counter anymore if we're 1-0. We're losing, so what's the point of playing it safe? Actually, I think I'll play it safe for the first half. Let's see if we can maybe hit them on the counter. But so far, no good signs that we can actually hit them on the counter. But yeah, what I was saying was that self-imposed transfer policy is just so stupid. The amount of damage Bilbao could do with the money they have and the support they have in the city that they're in is huge if they just didn't have that transfer policy. And what sucks more than anything is whoever was managing before me just really doesn't have any sort of youth potential, in the sense that he hasn't signed anyone of potential, which would make sense because if you're going to stick to your, you know what, I'm going to have to switch. If you're going to stick to your league and whatnot, sorry, not your league, your like Basque players only, then it makes sense that you should have a huge talent, a huge pool of talent coming through the youth ranks. But unfortunately, we don't have that. So it's going to take a couple years, and it's likely that I'm going to be the one who has to fail for a little bit before I actually succeed. And the chances of the board keeping me on, if I don't, you know, actually get into Europa League spot, which seems, I know it's just four games so far, and this is the fifth that we're losing, but it seems absolutely impossible for me to actually get to that stage. You know, all things considered. And actually don't know. No, I'll do that. Yeah, but at this stage it just seems impossible for me to actually go on and kick off into Europa League. We've had some strange results. It hasn't been the easiest of starts, of course. We're gonna start getting some good games after this Barcelona one. Or supposedly supposed to be easy games, but you never know in this game, really. Apparently, I should be telling my players off, but considering that we were never favourites, I'm just going to have to tell them that they've been unlucky. It always works. They always get some more confidence. Doesn't necessarily mean they get into a result, but at least they're a little bit happier and maybe can push on and perform a bit better. We've got our star striker performing poorly. That's not good news at all. I'm going to have to tell Danny to relax a little bit because he's on a yellow. But yeah, I mean, I don't know. I just, as soon as I saw that transfer policy, I knew I'd have an issue with it, but I thought I'd just carry on and see what happens. Of course, I can't immediately resign. I mean, I can, but I don't want to immediately resign after joining a club. You never know. You know, if we were being successful, then why not? But, you know, the more I play this Athletico Bilbao save, the more I think I should have waited on to see if Watford were going to offer me the job and then taken that instead. You know, being in the Premier League would have been better. Just because we haven't been there, not because of, you know, any sort of biasness to the league. Mourinho is through here. Does Canisius do something? It is just behind Garcia. And, oh, that was a clear-cut chance. I don't know why the game isn't considering it, but we are upping up in the stats. We are causing Barcelona some problems, so hopefully we can get an equaliser here. We get a penalty instead, and I think Piqué will get a second yellow for a handball. If he doesn't, I'd be surprised. That would be very poor refereeing, and it looks like it will be. Incredibly poor refereeing. That's just completely stupid. How can we not get a second yellow for a deliberate handball in the box? I guess we'll just have to live with that and see if San Jose actually scores his penalty. No, can't consider us one, you know, drawing. Of course we can't. And it looks like that will be the end of the highlight, I think. Yeah, it is. And now we're just going to have to make some serious changes. Asia. Well, first off, we have to take off Danny and San Jose. Why is my centre-back taking penalties? Is he good in penalties or something? What can Oscar play as? Does it say Pepe Pelos taking 14? But still, I don't think... I haven't said it myself, I just leave it to the players themselves, because more often than not, they're correct. And he's got decent finishing too, 14 finishing. He should be putting that in the... Maybe the pressure got to him. And I think I will have to take off my striker, despite my backup one not being ready whatsoever. No, I don't like that actually. I'll bring on Suesta. Fullback. This should give a little bit more balance to our side. I'm not really a fan of making three changes in one go. I like making two changes in the one and the later on. That's only for losing, of course, but my team's a mess of poor fitness and poor performances. Only my goalkeeper can actually say he's had a good game here today. But considering, you know, the stats here, it's pretty even. Of course, not in the shots or shots on target, but clear-cut chances and half chances. We're close. The point is we're close. Not even, but close. And we do deserve some credit there, but, you know, if the result is still 1-0, then it's pointless. And now it's 2-0. So credit doesn't matter for anything. So we're going to go on attacking now, even though that's going to be incredibly stupid against a side like Barcelona. But we might as well try and get a goal, put some pressure on them, and maybe get a late equaliser afterwards. Forgot about this 3D replay. Goalkeeper just flapping there. Completely exposed. And, yeah, just not happy. Not happy about this result. Performance is decent, but the result is what matters in the end of the day. And for some reason, that highlight went on endlessly, trying to show us the celebration as well. Neymar's going to be bringing the ball forward here, though, and DeMarcus just tells him, nope, sorry, I'm going to send my player through instead. And of course, Villa Libre shows me that I should have actually taken him off, but that was just stupid beyond words. Absolutely stupid. I could have gone into overload, but it just doesn't make sense with us being 2-0 down. And it looks like it could be 3. Coutinho's got the ball here. Barcelona have signed him, yes. Pique probably shouldn't be on the pitch anymore. Mascherano, and it is us who are through on the counter. Can we do something here? Muneyin, come on. He finds Garcia, finds Villabar. And this time he does at least hit the target. But we've had more clear-cut chances now than Barcelona have. And that is just pretty much the story of our season so far. A lack of efficiency, a lack of clinicalness. And we could have, based on clear-cut chances, we could have been 3-2 up against Barcelona. And instead, it looks like we'll be losing 2-0 and possibly 3-0. To Sturgeon, he's going to take his time to pick someone out. He goes to Inigo Martinez, Digne now, Neymar Jr. What can he do? Who's Andre Horta? Suarez is through again. That's probably his hat-trick, but I don't even know if... No, it's Messi who scored the first goal. But yeah, 3-3 in terms of clear-cut chances now at least. But in terms of, you know, performance, I think we did match Barcelona. I think it's fair to say we did match Barcelona. We just did not finish like Barcelona. And that's testament to, obviously, our striker. Our striker's young, 20 years old. He's going to be feeling the pressure. But yeah, we don't have anyone that we could have signed. That's the issue. With that limited transfer policy. Otherwise, there would have been huge improvements I would have made to my squad. We could have easily challenged for the title, I think. I had 50 million in the bank. A number of some good players here. Some of them are, you know, like leading players for the league. Some of them are... okay, I told them that we were underdogs and they had good effort, but apparently that pissed them off. Yeah, we have some leading players, a couple of good ones, not really anyone decent, so that means we have a good squad overall, good strength, and a couple of additions would have made a big difference here, especially in the striker, you know, because we've got him who's just suited for the league, it says. I don't think, because he's still young, hasn't really said that what his potential is just yet, or rather what's his ability. But this target man here, incredible potential, but he's still suited to second division. You can't expect him to be doing something against Barcelona, you know. But yeah, let's see what we can do from here. And yes, definitely sorry Athletico Bilbao, lose yet again. And unfortunately I won't be resigning. I'll have to be, of course it's still crazy early to resign in the first place, but I meant later on, I'm just gonna have to wait until they fire me, because I don't want to keep that whole reputation as a resigner on. It doesn't look good at all. I'd rather be fired than resign. Of course either one doesn't look good, but it makes more sense to be fired than it does to resign. In terms of when we'll be back, of course, as we mentioned, 5 games time. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll be showing you Europa League next against Krasnodar. And of course, you know, if you did enjoy the episode, and as always, please do hit the like button and subscribe for more daily Football Manager 2017 content. And as always, thank you guys for watching.